first. That's this Thursday, then Melbourne on the 27th. That's next Wednesday. And then on to Brisbane for Saturday, the 30th of July.
Sempre una amabile leggiadro viso, in pianto il viso e menzognero. La donna è mobile, qual più dal vento, muta da cento e di pensier. E di pensier.
Roberto Alagna, first of all, welcome to Australia. Your
Thank
first
you
time
very
here.
Much. It's nice to hear the great Giuseppe Verdi, eh? La Donna Mobile.
Do you still love that aria?
Oh, sure. You know, it's amazing, this aria, because so simple, you know, after listening just one time, you can sing the aria. Giuseppe Verdi was a genius.
And they did that in Verdi's day, didn't they? I mean,
the
next
exactly.
morning after the premiere, the streets, people were singing it in the
streets.
Create
a hit.
Roberto, what have you got in store for us with these three concerts coming up over the next 10 days in Australia?
Mm-hmm. I'm so excited, you know. I will start today to rehearse with the orchestra. It will be the first contact. And after that, it will be the concert with the people and the audience of Australia. I'm so excited. And it's quite moving to come and to make a debut here in a new country for me.
And you're not just singing the operatic hits, but you're singing other music as well, aren't you?
Also operatic moments also. But, you know, in fact, you know, Naples was the capital of opera. 2 centuries ago, and I wanted to make a tribute of those wonderful composers, because they were the creator of opera. And you know, every aria in this concert, it's very operatic and very lyrical.
Now, you've done very well for a person who describes himself as shy.
Yeah, I was shy.
yes, it seems like a contradiction, really, for an opera singer.
You know why? Because here I'm playing the tenor. I am in the character, but you know, I'm shy in a private life. But when I'm doing interviews, I'm still shy. But I try to manage this shyness, you know. But it's very important for me because I'm very enthusiastic with this concert, and I want to give the more emotion I can to the most people I can.
You say that you're kind of playing a role. This might resonate with what I'm about to talk about. But, Roberto, I have some winners to announce in the competition that we ran here on ABC Classic FM to give away tickets to your concerts.
Oh, so nice.
Yes, and listeners had to tell us what opera, film or TV role they would most like to cast you in.
Oh. I'm very curious now.
And we had a lot of funny and very creative entries. I'll give you the first one. This is actually for the last concert of the tour, Brisbane on the 30th. Of July. The winner is Anoni McRae Clift, and she comes from Gunelabar in New South Wales. And Anoni, Roberto, she said, I would like to see Roberto as Superman. That
Whoa.
Would be my choice. He would sing a Lucha Van La Stella as he flies from Krypton to Earth, La Donna Mobile as he romances Lois, and he finishes with a rousing chorus of "What kind of fool am I?" as he dispatches his enemies and marries lovers.
It's amazing, wonderful.
Very creative, isn't it? Actually, you singing in films, though, it isn't so far-fetched, is it? Because you were very influenced by a film star tenor.
Yeah, sure. You know, today everybody are influenced by cinema, but because you must be believable on stage and you must play like an actor. Sure, we are not actor because we are opera singers, but we are close now. It's very, very funny because I received a lot of offer from cinema. The last one was Gérard Depardieu, you know, the great French actor. He proposed me to play with him in The Three Musketeers, and he proposed me the role of D'Artagnan. It was funny, and I said, you know, Gérard, I can't do that because if you do a version singing version, maybe. And he said, oh, you're wrong. You must play this this character. It's wonderful. And another time, when I was young, I received an offer, wonderful one, and I was too shy to accept that. I received a proposal to be in a biopic of Mario Lanza, and I was supposed to be Mario Lanza young, the young Mario Lanza.
That would have been your dream, wasn't it?
Yeah,
it? Because
it was
your
amazing.
Hero.
Exactly, but I was too shy. I was just 18, and I spoke with my mom, and my mom was afraid also, and I said, okay, no, it's too early. But I was wrong.
Well, Roberto, there's a second winner as well, the Melbourne winner for the 27th of July concert. That's next Wednesday week. This is Joanne Dobrovich from Eltham. And Joanne, you say, Mr. Alagna would be a great replacement for Cary Grant in An Affair to Remember. He could sing and we could swoon, as I did when I saw him in Romeo and Juliet in Standing Room at the Met in New York, where I first met my Australian husband. Do you remember that production, Roberto?
Romeo and Juliet,
at the Met, yeah, what was it like?
Yes, it was wonderful. And, you know, it was the first broadcast for the Metropolitan, the first time. And everything was new, and we were very, very excited with Anna Netrebko. It was the first time the broadcast around the world.
Now, what I can't understand is Joanne said that she swooned when she saw you there, but she ended up marrying someone else.
Life is sometimes very strange, you know. you receive some surprises.
And the final winner is Gail. Alberto from Sydney. Gail will be going to the concert in Sydney on the 21st. That's in 2 days' time, Thursday evening. And Gail says, I think Roberto should have a cooking show called Alagna Does Lasagna. And
this is good for publicity.
And he just sings the ingredients and method. Do you cook at home, Roberto?
Oh, sure. I like to invent some dishes, you know. I like that, you know. I made sometime, you know, something very strange. I made an omelette blue. Like blue jeans.
How did you do that?
It was quite strange, yet, but it was good.
Now, Roberto, while I've got you, I have to ask you a question I've been wondering about. I have heard that when you were younger, you went and you interrupted Luciano Pavarotti when he was doing a CD signing and announced that you wanted to be a tenor. Is that a true story?
It's quite true, but it was not me because I was too shy, and you know, and it was somebody else who had this courage to say that to the maestro. And after that, he invited me in Pesaro to do his competition, and I won the competition 2 years later.
Wow, that was a real career break for you, wasn't it?
It was a great moment for me because Luciano was a god for me, and I had such a great admiration for this singer, this artist, but also for this man because he was a very special man.
Now, Roberto Alagna, you're not the only talented member of your family, are you? You've got some very two talented brothers as well.
Yeah, too much.
Are you still rivals like you probably were as children?
You know, in my family, everybody has a talent. Because we have a lot of artists in the family. You know, a painter, sculptor, a poet, composer, musician, singers, actor, everything. And because it's a typical Sicilian family, you know, everybody wants to do something artistic, but it's in the blood, you know, it's like this. And I'm very, very lucky because in fact my real conservatory was at home, you know. I learned everything with them.
Yes, and but you've got a brother who writes music for you, don't you?
Yeah, sure. He's just in front of me. It's David. He's here with me in Australia, and he's a very good composer. And we made this opera together, and with the other brother also, Federico. And this opera, it's wonderful. I will sing again this opera next season in France. And we have also a wonderful DVD of this opera. It's a very, very, very strong subject.
And are you singing any of your brother's music while you're in Australia?
Sure. But I will sing an aria with the orchestration made by my brothers. And it's a wonderful one. It's named Senza Nishun, Without Nobody.
Well, Roberto Alagna, thank you so much for talking to us on mornings here on ABC Classic FM. We'll really look forward to the three concerts over
Great
the next.
Great pleasure. And thanks for your winners. They have a wonderful imagination.
Thanks, Roberto. Bye-bye. We'll go out Good with day. Another track from you. Yes, just a hint of what's in store when Roberto Alagna sings in Sydney on Thursday night, then on to Melbourne the 27th, that's next Wednesday night, and then on to Brisbane for Saturday the 30th of July. And congratulations again to our winners in the Roberto Alagna competition. Sydney winner, Gail Alberto from Sydney. Melbourne winner, Joanne Dobrovich from Eltham. And in Brisbane, Anoni McRae-Clift, who comes from Gunelabar down there near Lismore. Congratulations to you all. You're all going to hear Roberto Alagna in concert, and thank you for your entries.
Hi, this is Julia Fredersdorf from Baroque Trio Latitude 37. You're listening to my favourite classical music station, ABC Classic FM.